Hey guys, I'm ready to go to my apartment on the Citadel, but before I started the video, I clicked the rapid transit and voila! It's not there. So what I did is I changed maps and it's still not there. So I thought to myself, maybe I can only access it.
Yes, Sergeant.
From the Normandy,
no.
As I dock. Let's try that. Although it's extremely irritating that you can no longer. I think I had the opportunity to go to my apartment using the rapid transit. It's strange. Nah. I'll get over it. Now let's dock, and yes, it seems like I can only go to my apartment from the ship, which is stupid if you ask me. Look, I'm using the rapid transit. Alright, I'll stop asking questions. Oh boy.
I've got Admiral Anderson on the QEC, patching him through to you now.
This huge thing is mine. I wish I had this in real life.
Shepard.
Admiral, how are you holding up?
Day by day, Commander.
Yeah. Hackett sent me a message about this apartment.
I want you to have it. Take it off my hands.
Oh, it was
his. Are you serious?
You need a place that's yours. Somewhere to recharge. Clear your head. Kaylee wanted us to settle down there. Thing is, the longer I'm on Earth, the less I want to leave. And I want as few loose ends out there as possible. Like I said, you'd be doing me a favor.
This is amazing.
That's very generous.
It's practical. We need you in the best shape possible. Rested. Focused.
If you say so. Thank you.
And make yourself at home, dammit. It's yours now.
I'm sure I can manage.
Okay, good. Been meaning to do that for a while. I'll talk to you soon.
Do I have a pool table?
Be careful out there, Anderson.
Do I have a pool?
You too, Shepard.
I don't think we can fit a pole in here, but it's absolutely beautiful. As I said before, man, I wish I had this kind of space in real life.
You never asked me about this, but my wife just called.
Oh?
My ex-wife. Nobody likes to talk about the toll that long months apart can have on military relationships.
I received a new message.
She wasn't military. She couldn't handle it. But it's not even about military and non-military, dammit, it's spaceflight. Spaceflight. Finding the mass relays, miracles of engineering. Human imagination rising to meet our desires. We pay a price for that curiosity, that drive. Our relationships suffer. People we love suffer. But that's reality. And it's worth the cost. I must have thought it was. I guess I still do. In the end, you just have to hope you made the right choices.
Don't we all? Okay, there's another note from Anderson.
The Normandy? A brand new ship. My ship. You don't forget that moment. The first time you're standing there, the whole crew looking to you for direction. Unforgettable. I'd led men and women before that. Seen a lot of combat already. Always managed to find my way home in one piece. Do that a few times, you begin to think you know better than the next guy. Maybe you do, I don't know. But if you're lucky, really lucky, you find yourself on a good ship, in front of a good crew. A crew you can trust with your life. Gifted. Disciplined. Brave. All of them. Eager to set sail into the endless black ocean. I still remember my XO asking what my orders were. Shepard, I said, let's see what we can find.
Very nice look inside the mind of Admiral Anderson. Look at this, I have a bar. Wow.
Embarrassing moment? I've got more of those than anyone will ever know. Only way to learn something. But if I had to pick one to share, just gotten promoted to M7. Full of myself, king of the castle. Found myself buying drinks for undesirables in some rundown bar in the wards. They toasted my recent promotion. Hell, they would have toasted Batarian slavers if it had got them more drinks. About the time my money ran out, my new friends turned on me. I was outnumbered. Things didn't look good. My plan to get out of there involved lots of punching. Well, that worked for a while. Then a table hit me. Or I fell down. When I came to, I saw a Salarian putting the rest of the troublemakers down. A Salarian? Moved like a damn cat, I swear. When everybody was out cold. Or running. He walked over and helped me up. N7, he asked. Yes, sir, I replied. He looked over my collection of unconscious friends, nodding. Not bad, human, he said. Then he walked away. I had met my first specter. Learned an important lesson that day. No matter how good you think you are, there's always somebody quicker, faster, and a hell of a lot smarter than you just around the corner.
Ain't that the truth?
Kept me alive more than once since then.
Yep, totally agree. Is this real fire? I don't think it's real fire. I think it's holographic fire. Oh no. Don't tell me this is real fire. These are logs. Is this real fire? I don't know. What's this? Stereo control. Oh, I don't think I'm gonna push that. I don't want any copyright strikes, but I'm still gonna try it a bit. Okay, no. Alright, we've looked there. Is there anything else? Jesus Christ, this thing is huge! It seems I have some messages over there. Okay, we'll get to it. Not on... I won't go there until I finish my tour. Oh?
Okay. I have your new questions here. As a leader, do I ever feel that the end justify the means? Spirit of law over word of law. I'm not going to touch that with a 10-foot pole, but I think I know what you're after. You're referring to the way I arranged to happen.
No, come on.
Okay.
I should not have gone that far.
I have your new questions here. As a leader, do I ever feel that the end justify the means? Spirit of law over word of law. I'm not going to touch that with a 10-foot pole, but I think I know what you're after. You're referring to the way I, arranged to have the Normandy released to Commander Shepard before the Battle of the Citadel. I'm not sure how valuable hindsight is to the military. Obviously, it worked out for the best. Without the Normandy and Commander Shepard free to do what they needed to do, what we needed them to do, Saren might have taken the Citadel. I think it's clear what a different galaxy this would be if that had happened. I did what I had to. If I had been wrong, I would have gladly accepted the repercussions. The real trick is never being wrong. If you're looking for more action and less philosophy in these notes, let me know.
I don't know who he's talking to exactly. Stereo control, no thank you. He's definitely not
sure,
addressing me.
Forced to fight a lot of battles alone. God only knows how he got out of some of that. sometimes he forgets. There's a whole bunch of people who lose sleep over him getting back home. Maybe it doesn't need to be said. Maybe we're too dumb to say it. Soldiers like the commander are rare. Men like Shepard, even more rare.
All right. What's this? Anderson ANN interview.
A few months ago, I had a chance to sit down with one of Earth's most decorated soldiers, Admiral David Anderson. He was kind enough to answer my questions and
Khalees Al-Jalani, okay.
Career. Today the Admiral is on Earth, leading the defense of our home against the Reapers. We have no communication with him or any soldiers on Earth, but we can't forget what they're doing for us. Tonight's show is dedicated to all of the soldiers out there, fighting and dying to keep us safe. Admiral Anderson, today marks the 30th anniversary of the N7 program. Can you describe your first day of training in this now famous program?
The Interplanetary Combatives Training Program is all business from day one.
How so?
We're given basic gear, then separated and stranded on an asteroid with no nav data. The test ends when the last person runs out of oxygen.
Sounds daunting. What happens to the ones who run out of air first?
Out of the program. The best N7s can survive alone, but work together to survive even longer.
That's very impressive, Admiral. Deep space survival training. That has to be so difficult. All of it would take such strength of character. Well, just plain strength. But then, you seem like a strong person.
I'm sorry. Is there a question in there?
Make the man... I think she was flirting.
It's a bit of both, I suppose. Every soldier reaches a point in their career, sometimes more than once, when they are asked to give more than they ever thought they could. That moment is the test. I've seen men and women, almost sure to fail, persevere long past the point of breaking. That experience changes them. Others, with all the gifts and abilities, fail in that moment. Sometimes they pick themselves up and carry on. Sometimes they're just done.
What about you? What was your moment?
I've had a few. None of which I'd like to share. But I think the toughest tests are still ahead of me.
What makes you say that?
Call it a hunch.
Soldier's intuition?
Something like that.
Do you trust your intuition? I mean, do you follow your heart over your mind?
Well, it depends on the day. No, I suppose if I were to be honest, I do trust my instincts. The problem is, war isn't orderly, and the enemy is never predictable. Even the most experienced veteran is going to find themselves in situations they haven't trained for. In those instances, and there's more than I'd like to admit, your instincts are the only thing keeping you alive. That, and the men and women you're fighting beside.
But soldiers are only as good as their leader, isn't that true?
Yeah. A good leader can make an okay squad great. A bad leader, well, war tends to make examples of them.
What makes a good leader, then?
A good leader is someone who values the life of his men over the success of the mission, but understands that sometimes the cost of failing a mission is higher than the cost of losing those men.
That's a terrible line to have to walk.
Yes, it is. But war is a terrible thing.
Thank you for your time, Admiral.
Thank you.
The remainder of this interview was to take a more personal look at Admiral Anderson's life. It wasn't finished when the Reapers invaded. We can only hope that the Admiral and the soldiers under his command survive to tell us the rest of their stories. I'm Khalees Al-Jalani. Thank you for watching.
More like listening, but I still enjoyed it.
joined the military. Everyone talks about honor, duty, sure. But that's never the whole truth. It's 100 little things that add up to commitment. I joined because of a dog. Yeah, a dog. This patchy, mean son of a bitch that used to bark at me every day on my way to school. He'd snarl and I'd start running. Scared the hell out of me. I was just a kid. I remember being in a bad mood one morning. Angry, I can't recall why. When that dog started in on me, I snapped. Started barking right back. We both kept at it until we had nothing left. The dog never bothered me again. Why'd I join the military? Sometimes you just gotta howl to make things right.
Nice.
No, no, it's fine. I got a few minutes. First contact war? Yeah. I was there. My first real combat. First for a lot of us. I remember one night early in the war. Strapped to my seat as our transport approached the LZ. Everyone was dead silent. Just the sound of breathing. Good men. I trained with all of them. We were always joking and horsing around, but not this time. Just the rattle of the shuttle. And that heavy breathing. Everyone was thinking the same thing. We're off to fight alien invaders. Aliens. Think about that. We all grew up wondering what was out there. If we were alone in the universe. Now we knew. We weren't alone. We were in trouble. So there we were. About to face an enemy as different and un... So I turned to the soldier beside me, Hendrix, I think, and asked him how his mother was doing. Fine, he said. Why? Because I heard your mama so ugly the Marines thought she was a Turian. Almost shot her. I got a few smiles. Then Hendrix turned to me and said, Hell, Anderson, I heard it was a picture of your mama that started this goddamn war in the first place. Scared the Turians shitless. Everyone had a good laugh at that. And the boys fought great that night. Sometimes that's all it takes. A joke, a pat on the back. Just a little reminder that everything's gonna be okay.
I don't know about you guys, but I really enjoy listening to these. Bathroom. Oh, I can customize. Okay. That's good to know. Let's check the upstairs. Let's head up. Where can we go up? Oh, from there or from here? Let's go from here. Okay. Wow, this is huge. Upstairs too. I don't know what this is. It's probably art, but... These do look similar to the artifacts found in Kasumi Goto's loyalty mission in Mass Effect 2, if I remember correctly. In the vault of Donovan something, the crime lord.
Okay, so, tombstone data. Admiral David Edward Anderson. Not sure why anybody would be interested, but thanks for asking. I was born in London, June 8th, 2137. The last of three children born to Ursula and Paul Anderson. A nurse and a flight mechanic, respectively. But that's a little dry. And someone's gonna spice this up, right? Never been much for the spotlight. Anyway, where was I? It was a second marriage for my parents. They were almost 50 by the time they had me. My mother worked shifts, so my father would often take me to the base. While he worked, I watched transport ships and fighters take off. Worked his whole life around space travel, my father. But he never left Earth. Not for a day. He was a good man. But that's just a side note. Don't put that in. Who is it, Kaylee? Oh, yes, I need to take that. I hope this is what you're after. I'll get to the more interesting N7 stuff next time.
Okay, so he is writing his memoirs probably and is recording his thoughts to be later be written down and in a book.
The Turians. Well, I might not always see eye to eye with the politics and the individual, but I have a great respect for the Turian military. Any Alliance soldier lucky enough to take part in their training programs will certainly be better for it. Their precision, skill, and discipline come together in a way that's second to none. Not that I'm faulting our own people or training. It's just that after fighting Turians in the First Contact War, years later, I had the opportunity to observe and train on Palavin. It was a turning point for me. And I would encourage any soldier to try it. It's a unique experience to put yourself in the squad of a Turian commander. My commander was an uncompromising bastard named Bartix Oryx. If you can find him, just ask how the platoon I commanded was trounced in his strategy game. Humbly. But I've used what I learned that day many times. The xenophobes will have their say. But I think it's vital that we do more of this kind of cross-species training. There you go. And if you do find General Oryx, let me know. I owe him money.
Another bedroom. A huge one. What's that? A weapons bench. Nice. An armor locker. Quite interesting. And yeah, it's not really a pool. Oh, we can't go inside. Ah, come on. Please let me go inside. Ah. I hate you, BioWare. How could you do this to me? Alright, what else? What else? Another bathroom. Man, this thing is amazing.
You asked me to talk about the SSV Normandy. The Normandy SR-1. As commander of the Tokyo, I was consulted on the Normandy's design and on board for her initial training exercises. The average person probably doesn't know that the Normandy was a joint project with the Turians. Acting CO, Eli Zander, was no diplomat. She ran out of patience with Turian posturing and politicking during construction. The chief architect of the Drive Corps, Octavio Tatum, and his team of Turian engineers were in the CIC for final training exercises. Tempers flared when Zander pushed the limits of the stealth system, waiting to vent the IES. Well past what Tatum was comfortable with. I tried to calm the situation, but it still ended with the Turian scientist in shackles and a human Turian fistfight at Korra's den later. Funny now, when I first laid eyes on the Normandy, she was the most beautiful thing I'd ever seen.
She was.
Day after that training run, Admiral Wright found me on the bridge. She's yours, he said. Can't trust her to Xander. Send me a list of crew from the Tokyo you'd like, and prep for your first mission. Short command, thanks to Saren. Still, one of the highlights of a long career.
Okay, I think this is it. Quite interesting hearing Anderson's thoughts. We never really knew him. But after hearing all of these, I think we know him better now. He is a great man. Of that, we have no doubt. Okay, where is that message desk? I think it's on the right. Yep. Let's check the messages. Oh no, before we do, let's see if he can customize. Standard vanity. Don't we have that already? We don't have? Bathroom. Bedding. Standard bedding. We have this already, don't we? Kitchen. Standard. Oh, these are standard. We already have them. So it must mean that... Oh, we need a lot of cash. It must mean that we can further upgrade it. I don't know. better furniture, better wall decorations, better bathroom stuff, better beds, better kitchen furniture, better seating. Alright, I think I like it. Dinner at sushi. Place on me. At sushi, place on me. Okay, who's this? Hey Shepard, I've got a few things I wanted to go over with you with the Normandy in dry dock. I figured we could meet up at the Ryusei sushi place down in the wards. I hear it's the best. Joker. Sure thing, Mr. Moreau. I will be joining you in a second. But you know what I need? I think I need something else to wear. I'm on shore leave after all. That's if I remember where my bedroom is. Yep, here it is. Let's see, casual. Nope. 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 Much better. Nope. Okay, this. Now we look like we're on shore leave. Oh, we can exit the apartment. Very nice. I thought pushing that would prompt us to select where we need to go. Where are we exactly? I have no idea. We haven't yet seen this part of the citadel. Full of life. The lifeblood of the citadel. That's me. Yep. Nice shoes, Shep. Oh, I'm expected. They don't look very happy to see me go in front of the line. Alright. Nice. There's an aquarium in the floor. This locale must be expensive. How did Joker?
Good evening. Would the gentleman care for a cab?
Maybe later. I'm meeting a friend.
Very good. Enjoy your evening.
Evening. Thank you. Hey, Joker. Where, Joker? Okay.
Hey, Shepard. Not bad, huh? The sushi place is serious. Like, French guy at the door serious. Only had to save the galaxy twice to get a table here. You see the line outside?
Yeah, I did. Who's that?
But here I am, drink in hand. Best pilot in the universe and a rock star.
Any news from the Normandy?
You know, maintenance stuff. It's hard knowing a bunch of strangers are poking around in my ship. I mean, your ship.
Our
ship. The best
ship.
Thing we can do right now is Parker and let the techs do their work.
Yeah, you're right. Maybe an oil change, space tire rotation.
Right. Trust me, it'll do her some good.
Oh, I trust you. Not sure about those shifty aerospace engineers. Always stealing the silverware.
Let someone else do the work.
Relax.
Hackett's orders. You're on shore leave.
Yeah, whether we like it or not.
I'm sure you'll manage.
I may need a drink that comes with an umbrella.
I'm the first human specter. I'll get you two umbrellas.
Awesome use of power, boss. So... your email said it was important?
My email?
What?
I'm here because I got a message from you.
The hell? I didn't send anything.
Excuse me?
Commander! Excuse me. Sorry. Ninth business. Commander, this is urgent!
I don't think that's the umbrella lady.
No, it's not.
Commander Shepard, I'm Staff Analyst Maya Brooks. Alliance. Excuse me. Alliance Intelligence. There are people trying to kill you.
Yeah, I think he's aware of it.
Exactly.
No, I don't mean Cerberus and the Reapers. I mean other people. New people.
New people.
Someone is hacking your account. Comm channels, personal records. They're targeting you specifically.
Why would anyone want to do that? I mean, I know why, but who is doing
targeting
that?
Me? What do they want?
The intel isn't definitive yet. Last time I guessed without definitive intel, we almost landed troops on a gas giant, which is bad.
Hang on, Brooks. Take a breath.
She took that literally.
What do you know?
Excuse me, you don't have a reservation.
I don't think they care.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Tonight's performance is brought to you by random acts of violence.
I think we found
spread out, boys. Find
the man who wants to kill me. They don't seem Cerberus.
Stay there. I'm coming. Joker. Ow, my pancreas.
Hey.
Damn it.
Got one, sir.
Find the crew.
Sir, so there is a chain of command over there. They look military. I don't have a weapon.
Hey.
You used me as bait?
Go.
You used me as bait?
Yeah, I did. Get over it. Okay.
Did you see that? Savior of the Citadel uses this little bones guy as bait.
Alright. Hello, sir.
Bro.
Oh, boy.
Hang on.
Wrong button press. Come on, come on, come on. Oh, this pistol is not bad at all. Destruction drone, no thank you. Come on. Drones. Okay. Oh, here they come. More of them.
Commander.
No. Bad power. Oh, what the hell?
Commander.
Yes, what? What do you want?
Commander.
Yes, I heard you. Are we done? Oh, come on, shut up!
Commander.
I have someone down. Oh boy, oh boy, oh boy, oh boy. No grenades. No, no, no. Grenades are bad for you. Will you please shut up? No, bad power. Oh, I think I'm in trouble. Told you I'm in trouble.
Commander!
Shut the hell up.
Commander!
Oh! Oh my god, she's so annoying.
Commander!
Oh, no, 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 no.
Commander!
Please, shut up. God damn it.
Commander!
Oh, come on. Where do these guys come from? Oh,
Brooks!
God damn it. Oh! Oh boy. Oh boy, oh boy, oh boy. I'm slippery. I'm sleeping. All that water. Did I survive the fall? Without any armor? To break the fall? Come on, Shep. Come on, Shep.
Commander, I found a secure terminal. Are you okay down there?
Yep.
She's alive?
Feeling good. Brooks, you got hit.
I saw her get hit, exactly.
I know. Everything is a little bit bouncy.
I think you used too much.
So, can I help with anything?
Alert CSEC. I'll look for a way out.
I'm running out of clips. My health isn't that good. Okay. Hello. Hey guys. Don't mind me. And it started as such a lovely evening. Something had to go wrong, right? Guys, I don't care if the current temperature units still work. Put the new ones in along this section. The customer has permits and wants work to start immediately. Even paid up front with a crazy bonus. Get it done. Bach Frex. Citadel Air. Okay. Mr. Frex. From Citadel Air. Ooh, there's a long way down.
Brooks. I see some sky cars across the gap. Maybe a landing pad.
I'm checking the area. Transportation, no food, no laundry. Ah! It's a sky car lot. Scission Motors.
Get a shuttle over there.
I know I can see Scission Motors.
Okay, right.
Why do I have why do I need you to confirm that?
It turns out CSEC has the whole area locked down.
Oh,
it's gonna be a tiny bit tricky to get your shuttle. There?
Oh.
Keep at it, Brooks.
Oh, also, stay off your comm. Well, except for me. It's hacked. That's probably how they found you.
Who are these guys?
Jesus.
I don't know. But they really don't seem to like you.
Yeah, I'm sensing that.
No kidding. I'm trying to move to a safer location. What the hell is this place? It's a refrigerator or a refrigeration room or something. Hello. What you're doing?
Hey.
You're smoking? Are you supposed to smoke in this area, sir? Well, your lungs? I'm not finding any ammo, which kind of worries me. But then again, my powers are okay.
Open the door.
CSEC shut the whole area down.
CSEC has shut the doors. What's going on?
Oh, there's a CSEC line over there. Maybe I can get help from the officers. Don't tell me C-Sec is trying to kill me. I don't buy that. Oh, ammo. Nice. I hate you, drone.
Shepard, can you hear me?
Okay. I'm fine. Might need a little backup.
You scared me there. Joker explained what happened. I'm on foot.
Ashley?
Excuse me, who is this? You're on an unsecured channel and you're putting Commander Shepard in danger. What? Who is this?
Hang on. Joker mentioned staff analyst Brooks, yes? That's her. Everybody play nice.
She is so overprotective. Okay, maybe some more ammo, please? Pretty please? Thank you. Not that much, though. Come on, oh! Is this my... Is this all the ammo I can have? Okay. Data pad. From Easy Meat. Easy Meat, okay. We do not make anything that tastes like Krogan, and certainly not barbecue Asari. Oh, Jesus. That's not the sort of business we do. Please restrict your orders to what's in the official catalog. Sincerely, Gret Bast, Shipping Director of Easy Meat Incorporated. Asari barbecue. Krogan meat. Yeah. Ah, come on. Oh no, you don't. Ah, I missed. Shit. Nope. I hate those drones. Really use my armor bonuses right now. Nope. His shields are, oh my god, are still up. Come on. Did I mention I hate drones? Fire in the hole! Okay. You know what? Let's track back and go the other. Let's grab some ammo. There it is. Let's go this way now. Maybe we'll have a better angle at them. Yes, yes, yes.
Oh. Gears here. Heard you're in trouble. Everybody's
oh, okay, Gears.
Good to hear. Things are a little dicey.
Okay, the team is any other way. Easily assembling. With their help, we'll get through this. Not finding anything of value, actually.
Please watch your step.
Oh, there we go. A pistol power magnifier Mark III. Thank you. I'm not using it, but I think Liara has such a module on her pistol. What's this? Festos, I know you're licking the fruit when I'm not around. Stop that. Seriously. Oh, come on. Credits, nice. 1.5k. I don't know if you guys can hear it, but
Brooks,
there's a police car
right, because of the,
outside, and the siren is really hard, really loud. I'm sorry about that. Okay, it went past. These are shops. Okay. Can I, yes, I can bypass. Should I? I don't think I have a choice, actually. That seems to be the only way out of here. Yeah, why not? Let's see.
Confirming Spectre authorization. Spectre access accepted.
What's that sound? Oh, seriously? Yeah. More of them?
Shepard, what the hell? I heard that from here.
It's all under control.
Is it?
More
of course you had to dodge, and of course I had to miss. Seriously,
they have guns, don't like.
Finally.
Very helpful, thanks. Commander, it would really be great if you could stay off the comm.
Hey, they called me.
I find these guys extremely annoying, and the fact that my powers are reloading so damn slow. Finally. Very nice. Who's shooting? Someone's shooting. Oh, I can't see who. Everybody's shooting at me. I fail to acknowledge the beauty of these sights. What the blazes? Oh. Who are these guys? Kind of annoying. Okay, then try to flank. Let's not let them flank. I feel so vulnerable without my armor. Oh, oh, God damn it. There's a sniper there. What can I do? Come on, pop your head. There we go. Let's push. I hate you guys. I really, really do. Let's push. Can I get inside this shop? Yes, I can. Is there anything for me here? Hatach, darling. Oh my god. I cannot read that. Look, here's the deal. You just can't say stuff like that to Giala. She will freak out. I swear to you. Her blue head will pop right off. I doubt her dad was a Vorcha. Sort of doubt it. Okay. More credits. I want my assault rifle, not credits. Old staff, I am aware some of you are considering leaving my employ and working for those hussies over at Mika. They don't care about you like I care. I super care about you. And the good kind of caring, not the creepy kind. Oh, Jesus. Seleucius Vess, manager of Van Allen Belts. Oh, we have a an upgrade. Variables. I think I tore my ACL doing something extreme. Starting to black out from the pain. Yeah. What the hell is this guy on? Jiba the Gipster Gublansky. P.S. Okay, guys, I'm really blacking. Okay. What's this? Assault rifle, ultralight materials, Mark 3. Okay, there's a trooper right over there. Hello. All right. You'll get yours soon enough. Come on, come on. Fire in the hole. You know what? Let's change the angle. I would rather go over there. Let's push. Hello. Oh boy. Yeah, goddammit.
Commander, there's a C-Sec shuttle inbound if you can get to the sky car lot.
I'm trying.
Okay.
There's so many of them, I have no idea where they're coming from.
Brooks out. Oh, over now. Brooks. Oh, damn it.
Okay, shut up. She is definitely a rookie. But a very, very good actress. Terminal. We've got some credits. Oh, I don't think those guys are friendly. Can they see me? I think they can see me. Oh, Ashley. Come on, Ash. You show them. Thank you, babe.
You, having a bad day, Shepard?
Yeah, I kind of am.
You could say that.
Landing pad is just over there, but it's behind a locked gate.
Let's look for a control panel.
It's good to see you, Ash. It's good to see you in combat armor.
Control.
I wish I were.
Right. Heard you fell through a fish tank.
We'll talk about it later.
Kind of a shame. Great sushi there.
Decision Dauntless. Looking for something unique? Something that will turn even your Asari neighbors green with envy? Look no further than Decision Dauntless. This rugged beauty doesn't just get from one glamorous vid perimeter to the next. It ushers you with a cloud of smiles. The best deal in the known universe, or my name isn't Snackle. Van Her. Manager, Snackle Van Her, Cision Motors. Ugh. Cision, stalwart, assembled by hand in fabrication tanks that are filled with filtered spring water shipped from the pure ice mountains of Imanea. The Cision stalwart isn't just a car, it's a life choice. That's the Cision Motors guarantee. Manager, Snackle Van Her, Cision Motors. I'm butchering everything I'm reading right now. What's this? Sniper rifle, ultralight materials. Alright. Alright. Decision Gallant. Ever want to experience danger from the safety of your own skycar? No. Ever need to explore the vast reaches of the unknown and be home in time for dinner? Yes. Decision Gallant can take you there. Seriously? Strong, silent, and willing to charge into battle along the most exclusive boulevards. So the boulevards are a battleground. Okay. You can breathe easy with Cision Motors. Manager, Snackle, Van Her, Cision Motors. Okay. I think I've had enough for now. Okay, guys, I'm going to stop the first episode of this DLC right here. After having read those advertorials or whatever they were. Thank you everyone for indulging. I hope to see you back tomorrow for a brand new episode. Have a great day. Bye bye.